Today we welcome Kennedy into the Catholic Church for sacrament of baptism. Through Christ's baptism in the River Jordan by John, he made this sacrament holy. Through water and the Holy Spirit, we will confer on Kennedy the sanctifying grace that makes us children of God and opens up the gates of heaven forever. So let us begin to begin all prayer in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And so I ask you, parents, what name have you given your child?
Kennedy Elizabeth.
And what do you ask of God's church to Kennedy?
Baptism.
I think
that's the answer.
My dear parents, you have asked to have your child baptized. In doing so, you are accepting the responsibility of training her in the practice of the faith. It will be your duty to bring her up to keep God's commandments as Christ taught us, by loving God and our neighbor. Do you clearly understand what you are undertaking?
Yes.
My parents, are you ready to help the parents of this child in their duty as Christian parents?
Yes.
Kennedy, the Christian community welcomes you with great joy. In his name, I claim you for Christ our Savior by the sign of his cross. I now trace the cross on your forehead, by your parents and godparents. Let us pray. God and Father of all that believe in you, you complete our joy today by crowning the precious life of this child with the still more wonderful promise of everlasting life. See in the fellowship of this community the faith of your church, and hear in our prayer the voice of your Son. As you promised us through Christ, bless with the power of the Holy Spirit this child whom you have called by name. We ask this through the same Christ our Lord. We shall now hear a reading from Sacred Scripture, a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Let the children come to me, do not prevent them. People were bringing children to him that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, let the children come to me, do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it. Then he embraced them, blessed them, placing his hands on them. The Gospel of the Lord. We come here today to celebrate the special sacrament of the Church that welcomes Kennedy as a member of the body of Christ. Just as you rejoice when she became part of your earthly family, we all today rejoice as she becomes part of God's heavenly family. Through the sacrament of baptism, Christ has given to each of us the key that unlocks the door to his heavenly kingdom. As descendants of Adam and as human beings, we inherit the sin of humanness, the lure of temptation, and the separation from our loving faithfulness. As brothers and sisters of Christ, through our baptism, we become one with Christ and the doors of heaven are open to us. Through the way we live our lives, we demonstrate our commitment to live the great commandment that Jesus told his apostles was necessary to inherit the kingdom of God. To love God with all our hearts, and all our minds, and all our souls. And to love our neighbors as ourselves. Through our actions, we live the life that Christ won for us on the cross. We live a life that Christ promised us will never end. And so today, we baptize Kennedy into faith, and willingly take on the responsibilities to help her grow in that faith. As parents, godparents, relatives and friends, as fellow Christians. We take on a great responsibility to show her the way to Christ. Through our love for each other, through our love for God, we become living gospels, examples that she will imitate, and so be drawn closer to Christ. It's an awesome responsibility because she will grow to imitate us. She will grow to be like us. She will grow to worship like us. She will grow to love like us. And so today we ask God to send His Holy Spirit to strengthen us all. That we may live our lives as lights of Christ. That we will live our lives as examples of Kennedy the Father. Dear brothers and sisters, let us ask the Lord Jesus to look lovingly on this child who is to be baptized, on the parents and godparents, and all the baptized. Our response is the word of your own prayer. By the mystery of your death and resurrection, bathe this child in light, give her the new life of baptism, and welcome her into your holy church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Through baptism and confirmation, make her your faithful follower and witness of your gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lead her by a holy life to the joys of God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Make the lives of her parents and godparents example of faith to inspire this child. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep her family always in your love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Renew the grace of baptism with each one of us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We shall ask Mary of the saints to intercede for us. Our response is pray for us. Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Lawrence,
pray for us.
All holy men and women,
pray for us.
Almighty and ever-living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan, spirit of evil, to rescue man from the kingdom of darkness and bring him into the splendor of your kingdom of light. We pray for this child. Set her free from original sin, make her a temple of your glory, and send your Holy Spirit to dwell with her. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We shall now anoint Kennedy with the oil of catechumens. We anoint you with the oil of salvation in the name of Christ our Savior. May he strengthen you with his power, and lives and reigns forever and ever. My dear brothers and sisters, God uses the sacrament of water to give his divine life to those who believe in him. Let us turn to him and ask him to pour his spirit of life in this font on this child he has chosen. Father, you give us grace through sacramental signs which tell us of the wonders of your unseen power. In baptism, we use your gift of water, which you have made a rich symbol of grace, you give us in this sacrament. At the very dawn of creation, your spirit breathed on the waters and making them the wellspring of all holiness. The waters of the great flood, you made a sign of the waters of baptism that make an end of sin and a new beginning of goodness. Through the waters of the Red Sea, you led Israel out of slavery to be an image of God's holy people, set free from sin by baptism. In the waters of the Jordan, your Son was baptized by John and anointed with the Spirit. Your Son willed that water and blood should flow from his side as he hung upon the cross. After his resurrection, he told his disciples, "Go out and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Father, look now upon your church and unseal for her the fountain of baptism. By the power of your Spirit, give to the water of this font the grace of your Son. You created humanity in your own likeness. Cleanse us now from sin in a new birth of innocence by water and the Spirit. We ask you, Father, with your Son, to send the Holy Spirit upon the water of this font. May all who are buried with Christ in the depth of baptism rise also in newness of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You called your child Kennedy to this cleansing water, that she may share in the faith of your church in eternal life. By the mystery of this consecrated water, lead her to a new birth and spiritual birth. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now, since she can't say these words for herself, you're going to stand up. Dear parents and godparents, you have come here to present this child for baptism by water and the Holy Spirit. She is to receive the gift of new life from God who is love. On your part, you must make it your constant care to bring her up in the practice of the faith. See that the divine life which God gives her is kept safe from the poison of sin, to grow always stronger in her heart. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, renew now the vows of your own baptism. Reject sin and profess your faith in Christ Jesus. This is the faith of the church. This is the faith in which this child is about to be baptized. So, do you reject sin as to live in the freedom of God's children?
We do.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
We do.
Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness?
We do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
We do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of God?
We do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
We do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus. Is it your will that Kennedy should be baptized in the faith of the Church, which we've all professed with you?
Yes.
Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so you may live always as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. Kennedy, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. See in this white garment the outward sign of your Christian dignity. With your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven. Receive the light of Christ, parents and godparents. This light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. She is to walk always as the child of the light. May she keep the flame of faith alive in her heart. When the Lord comes, may she bow to meet him and all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Amen. The Lord Jesus made the deaf hear and the dumb speak, and he soon touched your ears and received his word. Mount to proclaim his faith. You have put on Christ in him, and you have been baptized. Hallelujah. Dearly beloved, this child has been reborn in baptism. She is now called the child of God, for so indeed she is. In confirmation, she will receive the fullness of God's Spirit. In Holy Communion, she will share the banquet of Christ's sacrifice. Only God the Father and this the Church. In the name of this child, in the spirit of our common sonship, let us pray together the words our Lord has given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, giver of our life, human and divine, and he blessed the father of this child. He He and his wife will be the first teachers of their child in the ways of faith. May they also be the best teachers, bearing witness to the faith by what they say and do in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
We shall now bless our present. By God's gift to your Holy Spirit, we are born to everlasting life. In his goodness, may he continue to pour out his blessings upon these sons and daughters of his. May he make them always, wherever they may be, faithful members of his holy people. May he send his peace upon all who are gathered here in Christ Jesus our Lord. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And now it's my pleasure to introduce the newest member of our Catholic Church, Kennedy.
Hello.